Sheila wasn't here. Is she home with the baby?
No, she's out getting the sunbeam.
Oh, so you have a few minutes to talk?
Lauren, if you're about to launch into some attack on Sheila, you...
I am tired. My name is Scott. I don't want war with your wife. And I especially don't want it with you.
Maybe it is good that you are here.
Why?
Because I've been wanting to see you too.
About what?
Lauren, for your sake, for my sake, you have to back off this campaign you're on. I mean, before this whole mess gets any more out of hand.
Oh, you want to talk about obsession? Let's talk about your wife for a minute. She is completely obsessive where you're concerned.
You said you didn't want to fight with her anymore.
I don't want anything to do with her anymore.
Why does she affect you like this? What is it about Sheila that is so threatening to you?
Believe me, I'm not threatened by her. I don't trust her. She's high-strung, she is paranoid, she's nervous all the time. I don't know why she's freaked out. I'll tell you one thing. She has secrets buried deep inside of her that she does not want you to know about.
Well, Lauren, everybody has secrets. Come on. I told you the other day, and I meant it. I am just a man trying to survive, trying to make the most out of the hand I was dealt. The most important thing I got right now is my son. You know, Sheila wants to move far away from
me. I don't believe you. She's on that.
Yeah, she's on that kick again. And she's pressing me. I don't want to leave. For many reasons, I want to stay put in General City. You know how I feel about it. But I cannot live with this constant turmoil. Now, I don't know what I'm going to do about my marriage, but I can't make any decisions today. And I desperately need some time, some peace, before I can make any decisions.
You're still not sure about the future.
No, but if you don't back off, Sheila is going to take our son and leave, Lauren. That's right, she thinks you're obsessed. She thinks you're dangerous. She's frightened of you. That's why she wants to leave. And you're not going to give me much recourse but to go with them.
Why is she frightened of me? What have I done?
You come here time and time again. You badger her. You challenge her. You make all kinds of unsupported allegations.
This is what I am serving you to. Defending that woman to me?
Look, I am not going to live my life in constant turmoil. That means never seeing you again, Lauren. So be it. You have a very demanding career. It's not like you to get so hung up on a petty vendetta like this.
There's more to this, Scott.
Like what, Lauren?
I don't know. But if she is frightened of me, that is because there is a reason for her to be frightened. The woman is trouble, and you stay with her baby or no baby. I don't to think what she'll do to your life in the long run. Don't let her destroy you, Scott.
Looks like I'm not the only one looking in for Chinese tonight. Better once you eat something, really. And then you do that experiment, I know it's going to be just perfect this time.
Sheila, Lauren was here.
What did she want?
My peace.
Excuse me?
I told her to back off and stop badgering you.
And what did she say?
I don't think we're going to have to worry about Lauren interfering in our lives anymore.
Scott, how can you be so naive?
To leave us.
And that you were ready to relocate just to get away from me.
How does she react to that?
Bottom line, no more interference. She's falling to quits.
You believe her?
Why would she say something like that if she didn't mean it?
Because I believe Lord Fenmore would say or do anything to keep me from taking you away from General City.
Thanks for the turkey sandwich, man. It really hit the spot.
No problem. So how come Lauren can't out my plan?
I don't know. I guess she has something to do.
Boss, is something bothering you?
There's something nagging at me, and I have no idea what it is.
Since Lauren was here.
Yeah, what makes you say that?
She has been affecting me a lot these days.
Lauren is standing at television set, Sheila's mother.
That's nice.
And we called the freight company about delivering it. I guess they're having a heck of a winter this year, as opposed to last year. Oh my God, Lynn, that's it. He said last year they had a very mild winter. They didn't have any winter storms. Can you get me the appointment book for last year, 91, and bring it in here? There's something I want to check out.
I've got it in the file.
Yes, you sure can. I need the number for the Weather Bureau, the National Weather Bureau nearest to Grand Rapids. That'll do. Thank you.
Lauren pretty well, and I have every reason to believe she meant exactly what she said.
Well, I wish I shared your confidence.
Trust me on this, will you? She's not going to be bothering us anymore, so we don't have to pick up and leave town.
I'm not so sure we shouldn't leave Genoa City anyway. Even if Lauren does stay away.
What makes you say that?
There are so many bad memories here for me. So much has happened that I just want to forget. I can't help but feel a new place, a fresh start. It would be wonderful for both of us.
What about my work, my research grant?
Honey, you can get another grant at another hospital.
No, grant money is pretty tight these days. Come on, Sheila.
Can make it work if you want to.
I don't want to leave Genoa City. Now, come on, we're going to be fine. Let's just put the past behind us and get on with our lives.
Yes. I'm calling to get some information on weather conditions last year in the Grand Rapids area. The date in question is March 27th, 1991. Listen, this is very critical. Can you help me with this?
We'll take a moment to get that for you. Can you hold?
I sure can. Thank you.
Okay. Partly cloudy. High that day was 25. Low 13 degrees. Wind 8 miles an hour from the northeast.
How much snow?
No snow.
No snow? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. You're a big help.
Paul, what is it?
Lynn, Sheila wasn't with Scott when their child was born.
She wasn't?
She was at her mother's farm in Michigan. She claimed she couldn't get back because she was snowed in. But I just checked with the Weather Bureau. There was no snow. Not in that area. Not that day and not that week.
Paul, why would she lie?
Why wouldn't you want to be with the father when their child was born?
What the hell is going on with that woman?
I don't understand what this means.